Hey, what's going on? Scott here. I thought I'd do a little show and tell about my NES setup I have at home. So the first part is this EverDrive N8. I think there's an N8 Pro in the works with more features, but for now I just have the N8. So how these things work, there is an SD card slot, so just put in, ROMs, ROM hacks. So you can play Japanese Famicom titles, even Famicom Disk System titles. You can play Doki Doki Panic. You can on real hardware or US NES US hardware. Pop that in, and this is just a regular NES cartridge that you stick in your NES. So let me do that now. And once you power it on, get to a menu. It looks like this. So the EDFC part, that's some of the EverDrive software. You just leave that alone. Then you can make whatever folders or directories you want on the SD card to organize things. I have things kind of organized in like alphabetical chunks. There is a limit to how many files in one directory it can handle, so that's why I have little chunks here. Also does all kinds of ROM hacks. I've got all these like SMB3 ROM hacks on here. Randomizers, you can load them on here and play them on real hardware. Got all the collection of Famicom titles here. Options. I'll show you options menu first. This is very exciting. You do get one save state slot per game, so you can save state. I've got mine set to start in A and start in B to save or load. So you can save your state, and if you save again, it'll just overwrite that one slot. I believe the N8 Pro is supposed to support multiple save states. Game Genie codes, put in Game Genie codes if you'd like. So a random example here is, here's a SMB2J. Again, I'm playing on just a US NES console. We'll pick Luigi because why not? And so here, no Famicom really needed. I just play with this EverDrive, and there's no lag. Everything's on actual hardware. Nothing's emulated, and so forth. Get back to the menu. Oops. And so likewise, like Mega Man, I can play the Rockman, or one can play like Rockman Japanese titles on here on your US NES console, which is cool. And so that's the EverDrive part. There's another aspect here. Let me load up one game. So this is the Famicom version of Castlevania game, and it has different audio. I'll explain in just a second. So the Famicom had an audio chip that was not enabled on the US NES console that this game takes advantage of. And with the power of an HDMI mod, or high def NES, I can enable these different audio chips and enjoy the audio of this awesome title in its full glory, I guess you could say. And there are comparison videos out there on the internet of the NES Castlevania versus this Famicom version and the audio. So again, this is possible with the HDMI mod is allowing this. So HDMI mod, like I said, different video options, resolution things, add scan lines if you want that kind of thing. You can see which audio chip is being used. Pan the audio stuff left and right if you get really, really in depth there. So that is that. Let me reset one more time. Just for the heck of it, here's like a SMB3 rendo. Yeah, so here you're playing on actual NES console with a randomizer. Works great. Awesome World 4. So that's that. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.